Las Vegas rocks all around the clock. Las Vegas rocks, 'cause this town never stops. Las Vegas rocks all around the clock, 'cause this town never stops. Las Vegas rocks.
Las Vegas rocks.
It's the Las Vegas Rocks radio show. The show before the show. Join us for a fast-paced hour of celebrity interviews and entertainment news. And now, here's Ron.
For Las Vegas Rocks! Las Vegas.
And welcome to the Las Vegas Rocks radio show. And once again, we're broadcasting both on KMZQ, 670 AM, and on Facebook Live. You can see it all on the my page, RonGarrett/Las Vegas. And we're on right now. If you take a look, you can see us here in the studio. And we're waving at you with Tom Hillary, Gene Cerone, and Heidi Thompson, my guests today. We'll be speaking with them in just a few minutes. But right now, I want to talk about what this show is all about. Let's get the party started, is what I've been saying lately. Unfortunately, we back up. We get two steps forward, one step back, it appears. But our mission hasn't changed. It's to be the show before the show and promote and encourage and motivate local entertainers, musicians, singers, comics, and producers who perform and produce shows in the showrooms, lounges, dinner clubs, nightclubs, comedy clubs, show bars in Las Vegas, the greatest town around. My guest tonight, or this afternoon, or this evening, whatever time zone that you're in, we're broadcasting around the country, are Heidi Thompson and Gene Cerone, and of course my regular over there, Mr. Tom Hillary. We'll be chatting with them in a minute, but first let me do my shout-outs to all my friends out there who are listening today. Remember, Facebook Live on my page if you want to see what's going on. By the way, really can't hear much what we're doing. Everybody complained last week they couldn't hear the telephone interviews. That's because you need to listen to the radio and not watch Facebook Live. But we'll try and figure a way to be able to do that someday. I don't think it can happen, but maybe the technology will improve. Let's say hello to Rick Sachs out there. Hey, Rick, keep those restaurant reviews going. Josette LeBlanc, we love you, Josette. She's in town right now. She came in today. Hello, Josette from Los Angeles. Johnny Skaggs, John Scaglione out there in Tampa, Florida, one of the producer friends of mine. In Da Nang, Vietnam, David Arciero, who listens religiously, and he said he's on his way back to Las Vegas. When should I come? I said 2022 would be a good time. He says, oh, no hurry, no hurry. David, hello. Floyd Tice, he's out there in Henderson, and his buddy Bill. Of course, my beautiful fiance, the person I love the most, Tammy Morelli, she's right there at home with Floyd, who is her dad. Marty Carmo up in Reno, Patrick Barney and Susan Sam Shockley. Congratulations on your new video studio that you're putting together over there in Henderson, a great place. They're going to have a grand opening coming up soon. In Palm Desert, PJ Gia Maria. Hey, Goomba, glad you're listening today. Janet Conway in New Jersey. Gene Ferrari down there in Fort Myers, Florida. And special thanks goes out to the Tuscany, Bobby Mayo's, Chianti, and the Italian-American Club, because right now they're the only ones that are out there pushing to get the party started. And we're so happy they're doing that. Thank you, Jimmy. Thank you, Benny. We appreciate what you're doing at the IAC. Tom, you're a member, right? You're a member of the IAC.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You've been over there since he opened things up?
Yeah, I went there the first day when they had Sheriff Lombardo come in and do his talk. So, yeah they're back in business.
He did. And, did he bring that?
Shout out to Tony Sacca, by the way. He's the guy who got me in there. God bless
Tony
him.
Sacca. Well, that's who was the guy behind this show to begin with.
Yeah, exactly.
And thanks, we use all his
Tony.
Music. Thanks, Tony. And so we're glad they're doing that. So that's over the IAC. If I missed anybody, let me know, and I'll tell you. I'll go for it next week. So that's the beginning of the show. So let's get to Gene and Heidi right now.
Hello.
Heidi, Gene, hello, 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 hello.
Well, hello, Ron. And your voice is so amazing.
It is.
I just love your voice on the radio, or in my headphones.
Well, it sounds better in headphones. You know, it does. I even can sing a little bit wearing a headphone.
Does your fiance wear headphones?
She wears headphones when she's listening to music on her phone and in the house. But she wears those. Actually, she wears the little pods.
I got you.
You know, but she's home listening right now. Hi, baby. So, Gene, Heidi, wow. We go way back.
Yes,
and you guys are an amazing couple, and I've said it millions of times on Facebook and to anyone who would listen that I think you're probably two of the most talented people I've ever met.
How much do we owe you?
Absolutely nothing. I'm so pleased you came to do this show in the first place. I've been chasing you. For a long time to come on. And just Tom and I today and you guys, and we're going to be talking about basically your history of how things got to be where they are. And a lot of people know you as performers.
Right.
But the hidden secret is Golden Song Productions.
Yes.
And the hundreds and hundreds of jingles and marketing strategies and marketing programs and things you came up for retail operations and casinos and restaurants and all that. So let's go back to 1987, since you told me that's where we start.
Yes.
See, I knew by having Gene and Heidi on that I wouldn't have to work too hard today because they scripted the whole thing. So I'm very happy. That's the total professional that you guys are. I
Thank
knew you,
you
would do it.
Thank you.
And I really appreciate it. So let's start in how you two guys met. Let's go there first. Gene,
you want to take it, Gene?
Go. No, you go ahead. Go ahead.
Okay, well, I can tell you from my point of view, there was a gentleman named Frankie. What was his last name? Do you remember?
Frankie D.
Frankie D.
We all know Frankie D.
Absolutely.
Frankie D'Angelo, sure.
Yeah.
He asked me if I would go and judge a talent contest at a little bar.
And you know who was hosting that talent contest that night?
Who?
Tony Saka, of course.
How about that?
Yeah, yeah.
It all ties in.
It all ties in.
Well, then what happened? What happened?
Okay, so I was a judge, and at the time, I was mainly doing jingles and was known for that. I hadn't done the performing thing much in Vegas except for lounges and things, but just nothing of any notoriety. And so I was a judge with Darlene. You know Darlene Tony's...
Darlene Mia?
Yes.
Tony's former wife and Gene's
also,
former wife.
That's right.
She was also...
Right.
So at the time, the she was a judge,
club.
Too. So
Tony and I used to joke about that, actually.
Yeah, I bet you did. Yeah,
and
that must have been good.
Oh, you know what was really funny? Tony and Darlene adopted a dog. And you know what the dog's name was?
Heidi.
Yes.
I met that dog.
You did?
Yes, I did.
Anyway, let's move into
it. It was a little schnauzer. Wasn't it a little schnauzer?
I don't remember.
Yeah.
But I digress. We were, so here I am, I'm judging this talent contest, and I needed someone to perform with me for a two-week gig at the then Marina Hotel. I was doing a jingle for
and
them.
The Marina Hotel, of course, was the boys. The bent nose crowd was running that joint.
I love them all. Anyway, so I was doing their jingle, and the general manager of the hotel said, listen, I know that you perform live. Would you like to sit in for 2 weeks while our duo goes on vacation? I was like, I would love it. So I was looking for someone that could play keys and sing for me. And I met Gene that night at that particular club where I was a judge in the talent contest. Now, he had heard of me through the jingles, and I had heard of him through the grapevine, you know, about being a great musician and so forth. And so I didn't hear him play or sing. I just said, you know what, you're hired. And I gave him a list of things to learn. So I come back from wherever I had to go to a wedding with my then boyfriend.
Yeah,
I come back from the wedding and I meet Gene at his house and his wife's there and we go in and we start rehearsing and I hear The Time of My Life, you know, the song by Bill Medley and Jennifer Warren, and I think it's the record. But no, it was Gene and his sequences. And I just was like, are you kidding me? And I started singing with him and it was like, you know, butter. I mean, we just sang together beautifully. So we ended up going to the Marina Hotel, which was supposed to be for 2 weeks. Over 2 years later, we're still there. You know, the only reason that I left is because I went into Legends in Concert as Cher, and they kept Gene on until they bulldozed it. So that's how we met.
Well, the speaking of the Marina, the first building that is still there, they actually
they
incorporated that one high rise into the current part of the MGM, which I found interesting. I wonder if they dug up the floor and if they found anybody under there.
Oh,
maybe
yeah,
Jimmy Hoffa, who we'll be talking about next week.
Exactly.
But so you guys got going.
Yeah.
You went into the show, Johnny Stewart's show at the time, right?
Right. Mm-hmm. I loved working for John. The reason I loved working for him is he appreciated the best of the best, and he paid us well, and he treated me great. And what was really funny, though, is after I was in the Imperial Palace for about a year and a half or so, I got an offer to go do another show in Laughlin called American Superstar.
Right.
Well, John Stewart, you know, was telling people, don't leave. If you leave, you won't come back to Legends, which I can understand.
Yeah.
But American Superstars, this is a very funny story. I found out that the guy that ran the Flamingo in Laughlin told the then producers of American Superstars they could have the show if they had me.
So of course, that Bill Bigelow?
I don't remember who it
was. That's who it was.
But I found that out, so of course I used that
and
to my...
Richard Lingois, those are the two guys running that place.
I used that to my financial advantage, of course, and left Legends and went to, the Flamingo.
Now, this is the show that Donnie Moore put together.
And
Mark Callis. Mm-hmm. American Superstars, which wasn't a knockoff of Legends, but it was similar.
The only thing that made it different is there was a lot more focus on the dancing. I don't know.
And it was a USA theme. Yeah. It was America theme. So, So that was the main difference. And that they did, they absolutely featured the dancers a lot more in that show. That became a real focal point of the show as well. Yeah.
And that was
1989.
And I think it was the end of 89, maybe. Mm-hmm. I think it was the end of 89.
And then we came here, American Superstars, and we went into the Flamingo here, into Bugsy's showroom, which was very fun. It was a cabaret kind of a thing. And Gene became the musical director at that time. And then, of course, a little while later, I don't know how long I was in that show, but I decided that I didn't really enjoy promoting the show in costume, walking around selling tickets before the show in costume. I offered to pay someone $10 an hour to do that for me out of my own pocket, but the producers kind of said that I would walk around in the buffet line if they wanted me to and not complain. And I said, well, I love you, bye. And so, of course, they fired Gene after that.
Well, at the time, I was the marketing director of the Edgewater. In Laughlin.
Yeah, right. We were doing jingles for you.
Right,
babe.
And I came down to see the show. Donnie said, you got to see my show.
It was a good show.
It was. I went down there and I saw the show. And yes, you were out selling tickets. Mm-hmm. I remember that distinctly.
Yeah.
But also, But you were so personable. You were so warm. I didn't never met you before. And I'm thinking, who's this? She's really nice.
Aww.
You know, and you're being nice to everybody. And you're winking all over the place. And you know, really doing a great job. And I said, this is going to be a good show.
Well, I wanted the show to do well, too. Mm-hmm. And I really thought that, we could have found a better way to market it than have the stars out there showing who they are. Because then when the people come to the show and you reveal yourself, there's no, because they've already seen you. So I just thought that was a little strange.
I would never do that way. I would always never have the stars before the show. They would have to be after when you reveal.
But it really was a good show. Yeah. And I'm grateful that I got to do that and Legends. Gene actually went into Legends years later, and we got to work for about a year together at the Imperial Palace, too. He went in with the Righteous Brothers out. Mm-hmm.
Well, we're going to take a break right now.
Okay.
We're going to come back and start listening to some of the things that you guys put together for today's show and talk with Tom Hillary, who has been nominated to be on the Las Vegas Walk of Stars.
Woohoo!
Awesome. Cool.
And we're working on that right now, and he'll get his star right next to Elvis.
Oh, that would be awesome.
That'd be cool.
Yeah, between Elvis and Tony Saka.
He's
there too. We'll be right back.
At Lerner & Rowe, we know that car wrecks don't take the weekends off, and neither do we. If you've been hurt in a car wreck over the weekend, you don't have to wait until Monday to get the help you need. We have people standing by right now, ready to take your call, ready to give you free advice, ready to help you get the medical attention you need. You don't have to wait until Monday to call an attorney. In a wreck, need a check? Call Lerner & Rowe. We are the 24/7 injury attorneys, and we're available to get the help you need right now.
Lerner & Rowe is the way to go. Call 877-1500.
Scott Guido, managing attorney. Kevin Rowe is only licensed in Arizona, New Mexico, Oregon, Washington, and Illinois.
Sun Country Heating and Cooling is a premiered certified independent trained dealer that can fix or replace your broken AC system with an unbeatable combination of low-cost repairs and high-efficiency systems. We've installed more high-efficiency trained systems than any trained dealer since 2004. We are a family-owned and operated heating and cooling company. When it's 110 degrees outside and your cooling system fails, you can count on Sun Country Heating and Cooling for fast service. 702-617-8159. That's 702-617-8159.
The Alzheimer's Association and the Ad Council present the story of Tom and Levi.
Tom is the smartest man I know. He's been a professor at two major universities, been a teacher for over 40 years. One day, he told me that he was having problems in his classes. I think one of the students had asked the question and he didn't remember the answer. And I also noticed that he was letting his class out earlier than they were supposed to let out. And he was telling them that he's doing it as a favor to them, but I think in reality, he just wanted to get out of there. I was really starting to worry because I saw something was wrong.
Levi and I talked about how it would change our lives, but he was there beside me. and my love for him was just immense.
When something feels different, it could be Alzheimer's. Now is the time to talk. Visit alz.org/ourstories to learn more. A message from the Alzheimer's Association and the Ad Council.
There's no other place like Las Vegas to see. No other place like Las Vegas to be. Where beautiful mountains surround the town.
And we're back on the Las Vegas Rocks Radio Show. Heidi Thompson, Gene Cerronin in studio today. We're all wearing our masks. But why are you wearing a Nixon mask? Anyway. You know. Well, not those kind of masks. Oh, okay, I'm sorry.
Because my Gerald Ford one is in the wash.
What's that mask? You got a Tom Hillary mask on right now? You look just like yourself.
It's fantastic. It took me years to get this way, you know.
Tom, tell us about your movie currently out there right now, the one you wanted to discuss.
Okay, well,
the Honey Pot, your newest.
Yeah, Honey Trap.
Honey Trap.
Yeah, Honey Trap.
I say the word pot, it makes me crazy.
It makes you happy, Ron. That's what
you
you're
bet
trying to
it
say.
Does, and I can't wait till 6 o'clock.
Well, Honey Trap has evolved over the last couple of years. It originally started out as a Russian espionage action comedy. And I got involved with a Chicago entertainment lawyer, Corky Kessler, who I went to Sundance with him. And he said, as he's reading the script, I'd really like you to decide, do you want to go drama or do you want to go comedy? Don't go in between. Okay, Corky, if that's what you want, that's what we'll do. So we're revising Honey Trap right now to make it more of a straight drama. But as that's happened, I've also evolved the main character a little bit, Christopher Ingersoll Anderson. And what we've decided to do is make him, he's not James Bond, Jason Bourne, Jack Bauer. You notice that JB thing, because apparently those guys like to drink that stuff. Christopher's a guy.
Is that what it is?
So that's where it all comes from. That's why they're all JB. So Christopher Ingersoll Anderson. Get those initials, right? Mm-hmm. He's the guy that you all should be like and want to be like. He's the guy who keeps all his receipts so he can put in his expense account. He's the guy who wears his heart rate monitor, make sure he's getting better and stronger and faster and smarter all the time. So I'm turning him sort of into a more of an idealized, aspire-to-be kind of like character.
So it's a work in progress at this point, yeah.
It is, but I've just got the latest. As a matter of fact, this morning I got the latest version of it with my co-writer, Neva Friedan, who did the original tool. Box murders. So I think this is going to be pretty much the final version that we're ready to present to potential financiers.
So it'll be feature film number 3 for you.
Oh, no. It's
more?
It's got to be about around 4, at least four. Number 4.
Around 4, okay. 3 is not close enough.
No, I'm sorry about that.
I'm just checking. Yeah. Well, what's your other one? What is it? Ouija House?
Ouija House. We got that one out a little while ago. That came with...
Then you have Bikini Kitchen, which I'm dying to see that one. Bikini Kitchen, what can that be about?
Especially when it stars Stormy Daniels. I know you're dying to see
that's
it.
Right. That's right. That's right.
Well, I don't want to disappoint anybody, but it's actually a general audience's piece of video. It is available. And Stormy came out, and she shows you how to mix up various cocktails in her own inimitable Stormy way. And, of course, we had her mixing the cocktails because of, you know, the visual that would go with that. You got it, even though it's radio. But I actually did that.
Especially when you're shaking the martini.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. We told her to keep shaking because we kept making mistakes.
I get it.
Yeah, the camera was out of focus, Stormy. Mm-hmm, shake again. Mm-hmm. But yeah, I did that one quite a few years ago with a guy named Dan Frank. And it's available. I think you can get it on Amazon right now. And it is literally general audiences, and this is long before the whole, you know, she became a household name, so it was ahead of the curve.
How'd
that
happen,
one.
You know? Wow. Mm-hmm. We've gone through a lot. Let's not go there. Anyway.
Exactly.
So we're going to come back to you in just a little bit, and then I want to discuss the premiere of the Eric Roberts movie that we're going to do here in town in special VIP. Champagne guest party for showing his movie for the first time in Las Vegas in a showroom atmosphere, comfortable and certainly exclusive and by invitation only.
Awesome.
So we're going to be doing that soon. We'll come and talk about that. Let's go back to Gene and Heidi, and let's start talking about your jingle career and some of the things that you did for me and things you've done for others, starting with the Laughlin stuff.
Well, I'll talk for a minute. You know, one of the good things about Heidi working the American Superstar show in Laughlin for that year and a half, almost 2 years that she was there, is once the show was set, which was fairly early on, then it was just the same show twice a night, six nights a week. And so eventually she's like, okay, I'm kind of bored. What else can I do? And that was when she decided to see if she could, find a resource for a jingle or two. And she found you.
And I was raring to go because I love jingles. Yeah. I think they set the image. They create the whole thing.
Yeah.
It's something you continue to remember.
So at the time, you were at the Edgewater.
Yes.
And so that was our first Laughlin jingle we did. And then it just moved out from there. You introduced us to some more people, and as a result of that, I think at one point we did jingles for more than half the casinos in Laughlin at one point.
Let's hear some of them.
Yeah.
Okay. Jim? We got some jingles ready to listen to that were written
from
and produced.
What year?
Well, this is around 90. Yeah, it's around 1990, 91, right in there.
Okay.
Yeah.
Lord,
that Laughlin terrain. It's party time. Climb aboard and have some fun with the best little train in the West, the Ramada Express.
Roll River Resort Hotel Casino, we're the king of the road. 'Cause when you find your way to Gold River, you found the overlord.
I love that. I love that. Especially, hold that. We'll come back to that, okay? Can you recue it? I love that, especially you found the mother load. I forgot all about that one, too. You're reminding me of my days down there.
Well, that was Gold River when you went back, so that actually was probably 95, 96,
yeah, that's when I
like
went
that.
Back in 95 as the general manager there.
But Colorado Bell, I think, was the second one we did. That was Lawrence T. Lawrence
that's
T. singing that.
Right.
Yeah,
okay.
He was so great. Man, that was like, that to me is still one of our favorite jingles we've done. We had a blast with that.
Oh, yeah.
I know.
Lawrence T.'s great. He's still cooking.
Yeah, yeah.
He's still good.
He's back in Vegas again.
He's back in Vegas. Yeah. He's a community guy. He tries to help everybody out.
Absolutely.
He's an amazing character.
He really
great
is.
Friend. Great
you know,
friend,
and
yeah.
I like to hear from him, actually. Yeah. So after, and then I also heard the bell, which is, was it Jay Boyd that hired you for that?
No.
Or Jeff Cohen.
Jeff, yes.
Jeff Cohen.
Yes.
Jeff Cohen.
Yes.
Who worked with me in Reno when I had my ad agency in Reno. And he was still up there messing around with the ad business. And the job came available at the Colorado Bell. And I called up Jeff.
Yeah.
And I said, I need you down here because he thinks like I do. Mm-hmm. And we wanted to turn Laughlin upside down, which we succeeded.
Yeah.
So much so, I think they ran us out of town after a while. But we succeeded in doing it with all the things I did. And then he put that together for you.
Yeah.
But then because I did well and you guys did well in Laughlin, I was brought up to Circus Circus and in 1993. And in 1993, we had that big pink dome out back.
Right.
That's right.
Now, it's called the Adventure Dome now, but the name we had then was Grand Slam Canyon, with kudos to Richard Brand, who came up with that name.
Ah.
However, when we all got fired, they changed the name immediately.
Right.
No, we didn't get fired. They sold it and blah, blah, blah. Things went on from there, and we went other places. I went back to Laughlin.
Right.
And so Grand Slam Canyon, we had to open that. There was $120 million worth of pink glass.
Wow.
And the inside animatronics with the dinosaurs and all that, back when Jurassic Park was quite popular.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And some water rides.
Yeah.
And the slogan I came up with was Mountain of Thrills for that. And I asked you guys to put together some kick-ass jingle that hopefully would win an award, and it did. So are you ready to play that one now, please? The next one that was up there is the Grand Slam.
And this is my favorite jingle we've ever done.
This is great. Yeah. I'm going to enjoy listening to it again.
Canyon Adventure Dome! In Las Vegas, there's a canyon where adventure has a home. Circus, Circus has it, and it's underneath a dome. Grand Slam Canyon Adventure Dome. More than fun is a thrill.
More than fun, it's a thrill. By the way, I thought of that line, shaving, In the bathroom,
shaving. I'm sure you did.
And I was thinking, what am I going to do? What am I going to do? Mountains of thrills, more than fun, it's a thrill. And in the TV spot, I had a little kid say that. It's more than fun, it's a thrill.
Yeah.
And you guys, that was perfect. As a matter of fact, I want to listen. Can you cue it up again?
Which one?
The same one we just, I
number
want to listen
two,
to
yeah.
it again.
Okay.
Because it's only 30 seconds long.
Right.
And we worked on that. It was great. I loved it. Bringing it back.
Adventure Dome. In Las Vegas.
Tell Phil Ruffin he needs to give me a call since he bought Circus.
Oh, right.
And they're sitting with that pink turkey out back, and it really never did much. They had to stock it full of other new rides and put up the arcade up there and all that stuff to make it happen.
Sure, yeah.
But that's some good stuff, guys. That's some good stuff.
That was so great. And we had, you know, really, I think really because of you, we really were able to launch the jingle company again. Because as Heidi said, she was very heavily into that before we met. And then once we started performing, she kind of let that go to the wayside. And so we got back into it, in the early 90s and had a blast.
Well, we're going to take a short break, and we're going to come back and talk to Heidi about the nanny.
Okay.
And the things that happened there with your television career, and that's going to be a lot of fun.
Big career.
That's okay. I'm not going to tell it, but let you do it. We'll be right back after.
Las Vegas Relief Dispensary, your destination for the best deals in town. Get a half ounce of top shelf full flower from Vada for $130, plus it's eight for one penny. Don't smoke? No problem. Las Vegas Relief is a home of the infused cannabis beverage, Two Roots craft beer, Just Society iced tea, and the new Creative Water infused seltzer, located at 2244 Paradise Road. You can walk in or order online for express pickup or delivery at LasVegasRelief.com. That's Las Vegas, R-E-L-E-A-F.com. Use code radio at checkout to redeem a penny pre-roll. Keep out of the reach of children. For use only by adults 21 years of age and older.
Summer is coming, and so are those high power bills. Astronomical bills, usually due to an inefficient air conditioner. Upgrade to a Hisear air conditioner from Home Air Conditioning. Those old R22 units are not getting any younger, and they're costing you plenty. Cool your home for less. Call Danny at Home Air Conditioning to schedule an appointment at your convenience anywhere in the valley. Home Air Conditioning, 702-878-8367. 702-878-8367. License number 51994.
Would you like an air conditioning technician instead of a salesman?
Afraid you're about to overpay for that air conditioner from that national chain?
Then you need to call Home Air Conditioning for your new, quiet, and energy-efficient air conditioning system. And if you need service and repair, they fix it right the first time. License number 51994. Call Danny for your quote over the phone at 878-8367. That's 878-8367, online at homeairlv.com.
Learn more at She Can STEM, a message brought to you by the Ad Council.
There's no other place like Las Vegas to see. No other place like Las Vegas to be. Where people mount.
Everybody wave at the Facebook Live phone camera. Boy, things have changed, right? Now we use our phones for everything. Used to cost maybe $500, get a camera crew out and shoot anything right now. Now you just put your phone on it.
Your $1,200 phone.
$1,200 phone, not that one. That's a $45 phone.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah, because I don't need a lot. Right. You know, all you need is voicemail, email, and text. That's it. Pictures. That's all we need. Let's go to Heidi again. Now, you had a career on TV.
Oh, a very
teeny.
I mean, the thing is I was really well known for impersonating Cher,
mm-hmm.
and so I got to
and
do.
You still are. I mean,
yeah. Well,
five years. They've been doing it.
Yeah, exactly. But I got to be on some shows like Ellen, The View. But my favorite was The Nanny.
Uh-huh.
And I got to play Cher recovering from plastic surgery. But the odd thing is they didn't show my face. I was bandaged up like a mummy. So basically, they just had me use my physical appearance, mannerisms, and voice. Which, you know, it could have been fun if they had me waving from a car at the end or something with my Cher face on. But they didn't. But, oh, my gosh, I had the most fun on that show. That was probably one of my most favorite experiences ever.
Fran Drescher, right?
Oh, God, yeah.
Now, how long did it take to do the episode? Would you go to New York to do it? How'd that
we
go
did
down?
It in L.A.
In L.A.
And we started at, like, I don't know, 5 in the morning. And we got done, you know, maybe 12, 15 hours later.
Mm-hmm.
I had a blast and a half. I got to sing on. There was a drag queen that actually lip-synced to me on it for a song called Bang Bang, I believe.
It's on there. Yeah, it's on the clip.
We're going to play that.
One thing that's not on the clip, though, is they were freaking out because they needed a parrot voice. So I swore at somebody in a parrot voice, and they went, come in. Anyway, so they made me swear at the producer in a parrot voice, and I got that gig, too. So that was fun.
So you were there actually all week, though. You
spent
a week rehearsing, and then the show was
right.
12 or 15 hours
right.
one day. Yeah.
Well, let's listen to an audio clip from Nanny.
Last place he passed for Cher, SeaWorld.
So let me ask you this.
Well, we still had some more.
Right,
is there more?
There's more to the clip, yeah.
Cher. Well, sharing is what it is all about. Cher. Honey, no, don't tell me. Talk to him. I give and give.
You know, she's really very good with children.
But do you think that earns his trust? No, he still won't tell me who you are. Cher!
You were in the...
I heard you.
Yeah, I was in the mummy.
Mummy suit, yeah.
What was really interesting...
Are you sure it wasn't a head injury?
What was very interesting is...
Okay.
I never really got to rehearse that much with Fran. So when we were doing our scenes together, I said... Sure, you know, just, you know, she didn't know I was going to do that. And then she just came back with, I heard you. I mean, it was just magical. We had a blast on that show.
Well, that sounds like a lot of fun.
It was.
A lot of fun. So moving on to Gene a little bit, and we love you, Heidi, really do.
I don't mind moving on to Gene.
Moving on to Gene a little bit. You went back to Legends for some years here in town, but Gene also started doing the Righteous Brothers in Legends. Is that right?
Yeah. You know, Heidi kept trying to find something for me to do in the impersonation arena beside building tracks. At that point, I'd been building music tracks for American Superstars to accompany the band. So they had a four-piece band, and then they would have other tracks that were in the background that would fill out the band and make it sound like a bigger band. And finally, she said, you should do Bill Medley. And I said, well, I don't know. So we finally decided that maybe it was a character I could do. And then we needed to find a Bobby Hatfield. And so an agent friend of ours said, one day I bumped into her at a coffee shop, and she said, you know, if you need a Bobby Hatfield, there's a guy in a lounge band over at Vacation Village, which is now...
Town Square,
right? And
that's right.
The old Vacation Village place, right?
That's right.
So we're driving on the street one day, and Heidi said, let's stop in and play a roll of quarters. And I went, oh, that's right. That's where this guy's supposed to be. I wonder how we'll know which guy it is, because the band was, it was a five-piece band. We walk in the casino. As we're walking toward the lounge, suddenly they start performing Unchained Melody. And we look and we go, that's the guy. He sounded just like Bobby Hatfield. He looked so much like Bobby, it was scary. And so we talked to him. We had to do a little convincing to get him to agree to even do an audition. And the rest was history, man. He came in and just blew everybody away. And we ended up, like, within a couple of weeks, we were at Legends in Concert at the Imperial Palace.
And you had a feature part of that show.
And we were there for a long, long time.
Were you two in the same show at the same time?
Yeah.
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 At, here, here at the Imperial, at the IP.
At the IP.
Not down in Laughlin.
Right. Right. Yeah.
So, Doug Masters.
Doug Masters, yeah.
Yeah, and unfortunately he's passed away.
He passed in 2007.
And I saw that show. You guys were phenomenal. And you cut it so good. I mean, even the Righteous Brothers came to see you.
They did. In 1995, we'd been together performing in the show for about 6 months. I actually called the MGM Grand. The Righteous Brothers used to come in about every 3 or 4 months to the MGM Grand at the time at the Hollywood Theater and do their stint for about 2-3 weeks. And finally, one day, the guys in the office at Legends said, "Oh, we know Bill. We can get him over to see you guys." And they just never did. So finally, one night, I called from backstage. I called Bill's room. I said, "Bill Medley's room, please." And they put me through. And, of course, they were in the middle of their show, too. So yeah, I got a voicemail. By the time I got home from my show that night, Bill was on my voicemail at home. Because this was the days before cell phones that actually worked. So we couldn't call from backstage. So Bill was on my voicemail. So I called him like 12:30 at night. And he was just the sweetest guy, man. And he had heard of us. He knew we were there. So a couple weeks later, he and Bobby came over to see us, and they just had a blast. And I've got actually a clip on YouTube of that night when they came to see us. And it was an electric night. The audience was on fire. It was nerve-wracking and exciting and thrilling. And from that point on, we made pretty good friends with Bill in particular, Bobby a bit, and Bobby had passed away a while after that, 2003, I believe. But, man, we made a great career out of doing the Righteous Brothers.
Do you remember doing the Righteous Brothers at the Sahara Hotel that I hired you to do the show there?
No, it was at the Gold River.
At Gold River?
The Gold River.
Well, you did the Sahara. Did you do one of my slot clubs at the Sahara?
Oh, no. You know what we did at the Sahara? They gave Bill Medley the Louis Prima.
That was Tony it. That's Tony. A Tony did it.
Another Tony.
Yeah, and I gave Tony the room. By the way, I gave him the room.
Mm-hmm.
He didn't pay for the room. Anybody who thought that he did, I lied. And and you guys were there.
Yeah, we performed.
You performed. I remember that. It was terrific.
That was another great night. I mean, and we became good friends with those guys over the years, and still Bill and I keep in touch, and so it's just great stuff.
Well, let's listen to a little bit of you and Doug Masters.
And Doug Masters, yeah. That was so thrilling, man. I tell you, working with Doug was magical. You know, over the years, there's been so many great groups that, you know, like you look at Crosby, Stills, and Nash, and Young, if you want to include that. And by themselves, they were great talents. But, man, there was a magic when the three or four of them got together, you know. And there have been so many groups like that. And I feel like Doug and I found that magic with our act. I mean, there was just something that just really worked with that, and we were just so thrilled to be able to work together every night. We had a blast. So unfortunately, as I said, he passed in 2007. So now I'm like, we had 13 years together. It went by like that. I mean, it was just it was amazing. In the music business, you don't spend 13 years with hardly any other musician or singer. It's unless you're married to her. So now I've got my studio business. I thought, well, let me just do my studio business full time for a little bit and figure out where I'm going to go from here when Doug passed. And it took me 8 years to find another Bobby Hatfield.
Well, let's talk about that in just a minute. Okay. I want to take a break now. Come back and chat with Tom a little bit, and we'll move on. We got so much more to go and get this music out there. That's just terrific. Nobody would ever think that that wasn't them.
Yeah.
And your voice is actually, should I say it? No. It's better than his is now. And and I want to also think what you think of Bucky Hurd as well. So
we're going to talk about that.
We'll be right back. Yeah.
Freedom to roam while staying safe in your home away from home. An RV from Johnny Walker RV. Your safety is their number one priority. Enjoy peace of mind while shopping at any of their three giant locations on Boulder Highway. Travel RV style. No planes, no ships, or overpriced trips. Enjoy the great outdoors for as low as $119 per month. Johnny Walker RV. 57 years of service. Staying Vegas strong with you. Visit today or start online at jwrv.com. Keep America camping.
This is Lee Habib, and I get asked all the time why we do all of those segments on Our American Stories about people who found the American dream. And we do it because it's true. This country has great stories to tell, and we tell them on this station every night, because one thing I've learned is this: there's an American story in all of us. Join me for Our American Stories right here.
Heard nightly, Monday through Friday, 10 p.m. to midnight, and Sunday, 9 a.m. to noon, only on AM 670.
Now, Chuck, I know that you're the brains behind DLC, but you really have some amazing staff members.
Our customers just love them, Craig. How many loan companies do you know with thousands of great reviews on Google and Yelp?
None. That's how many.
Check this out. Quite a few of our staff even started out as Dollar Loan Center customers and had such a good experience, they came to work for us. Our goal has always been to make people feel comfortable and treat them with respect, and our staff nails it.
What's that saying you have?
Yeah, it's tough enough for someone to have to walk through a strange set of doors because they need a quick loan. The least we can do at Dollar Loan Center is treat them like $1 million and send them home with a few hundred.
Amen, brother. That was Chuck, founder of DLC, where you can get up to $5,000 in minutes at over 50 locations. You can also apply over the phone or online at don'tbebroke.com.
Licensed by the Banner Financial Institutions Division. Customer must meet the normal loan qualifications. Review loan qualifications. Visit us at don'tbebroke.com. Certain limitations may apply. Loans are subject to approval.
There's no other place like Las Vegas to see. No other place like Las Vegas to be. Where beautiful mountains surround the town. Your dreams and fantasies are all around.
And we're back on the Las Vegas Rocks Radio Show, keeping the spirit alive. Let's get the party started. Let's get back to where we were. We will. It will happen. Maybe not as quick as we'd all like, but I certainly know it's going to happen eventually, without a doubt. You can't keep Vegas down, but it may take a little while.
Right.
I think without vaccine, people are still going to be concerned. So that's going to have to happen. I'm not going to take one, but it's going to have to happen. Tom.
Yes.
Your movie that we're going to do a preview of.
Project Solitude.
That's right. Buried Alive. It's available now.
Yes, you can buy it directly from me now. The best way to find it is to type in Project Solitude Vimeo on demand. Mm-hmm. And that way you're buying it from me directly. And as the creator and financer of the thing, I actually get paid. So that's kind of nice. And
there's
I want to do that again. Yeah, I mean, it doesn't happen too often. But, it stars Eric Roberts, who's not only an Academy Award nominee. I understand he's also a Golden Globe nominee.
Mm-hmm.
Kowalski, who was out in the freezing woods of Green Bay, Wisconsin, during a harsh December to do this movie. So that's the kind of passion he had for the project.
Green Bay in December.
A bad December.
Doesn't sound like fun.
Outdoors. Wow. At night.
And the reason is? Tell the truth.
And the reason is because the way the producer tried to set it up, months and months and months went by. And before
then
we
the
were
state
ready.
Of Wisconsin gave you some money to produce, right?
Well, that happened too.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. If you want to come up here and freeze your ass off, it's okay. We'll pay for it. Well, thanks, Tom.
No, thanks so much.
Now, we're going to talk about, just a second, to talk about the upcoming showing. We're going to do the showing of your movies by invitation only. Yeah. We're going to lock down the spot. We're thinking of many different locations, and you're going to hear about it more. And all of us in Las Vegas are going to get a chance to see this movie. And in the VIP champagne setting, it's going to be superb and have a lot of fun.
Yeah.
It's awesome. Heidi.
Yes.
How you doing?
I'm doing fine.
You do all kinds of characters, by the way, not just Cher. Let me just share that with us for a moment, because I've seen your characters. They're incredible, that the people that you do, the old lady with the walker.
Well, the only reason I do comedy characters is for my own benefit, because I think of them in my head, and then I laugh really hard, so I decide to manifest them, and I manifest them and get videotape of them and then move on. But they're fun.
They're fun.
They're fun, yeah. It's a lot of work.
Well, you said you have to costume out like that.
It's a lot of work. But yeah, I have an old lady. Her name's Selma Schlockman. And I have an ex geisha named Sushi Bar. And, just some Dolly Parton whose corn cob boobs pop popcorn from menopausal heat. You know, just fun. Just my mind is a little
fun stuff like
that. Out to lunch.
Gene was telling us about his career. And unfortunately, we lost Doug.
Doug Masters.
And then you spent a long time looking for his replacement, or it just happened to happen? Tell us.
No, we were looking and looking, and I tried two or three different guys, and they just didn't work out. Just the chemistry wasn't there. And one day, Heidi said, "What about Larry G. Jones?" Because I'd known Larry for, I don't know, at that point, probably known him for 3 years or so, 3-4 years. Larry had his own show at the Royal, in fact, a few years back, and a great impressionist. So I said, and Larry's short, so it was great. I'm like, yeah, he's short enough to do the part.
Short is not a politically correct term, dear.
He's short. Anyway, he's like 5'4", and I'm 5'9", so,
what
you know.
What would be the politically correct term for short?
He's horizontally challenged.
Oh, okay.
Vertically challenged.
Just say he was the world's tallest midget. Leave it at that. Can't say so, midget either, right?
Right,
small
right,
people,
exactly. Yeah. So we called Larry, and Larry said, I've never done any Bobby Hatfield songs ever, not even on Chain Melody. And Heidi said, well, can you do a little demo of it, send it down to Gene, see what he thinks? The guy sounded amazing. And so he lives in Seattle now, so he's not in Vegas
anymore. We have a little of that here.
So I just put together a couple little clips of us doing some tunes from a live show. So at least you get a chance to hear
this
us
is you
together.
And Larry G.
Me and Larry
Jones.
G. Jones.
Okay,
yeah.
Let's play. To that show, when did that end? So, well, with the two of you. He's in Seattle now.
No, Larry's been up there, so I just fly him wherever we
need
to go.
So if you get a gig, you call him in.
Absolutely.
So you're still doing
so
it.
So we've got two shows booked in September. We hope that they hold. One is in the L.A. area, North Hollywood. It's a ticketed show, and the other is the end of September. We're in Wisconsin, mm-hmm. and we've got two nights there. So
but not at night in the cold.
Not at night in the cold. Well, September shouldn't be too bad in Wisconsin, so it'll be nice, yeah.
Well, I'm going to skip this next break because I want to come to... is that all right? We're going to skip a break here, all right? Or do I have to do it for the station's dollar bills? We got to do it? All right, let's take it right now, and then we'll have the rest of the hour to finish up and talk about the two divas and a piano.
At Findlay Acura in the Valley Auto Mall, they are committed to helping the Las Vegas community in this trying time. If you need any vehicle repair on any model, they are an essential repair facility and got you covered. They have oil changes starting at $19.95, free smogs for life. And if you mention this ad, they'll take 15% off the service cost. Plus, buy any new vehicle, and they have no payments for 90 days. Findlay Acura in the Valley Auto Mall, or online at FindlayAcura.com. Vegas strong.
Sun Country Heating and Cooling is a premiered certified independent trained dealer that can fix or replace your broken AC system with an unbeatable combination of low-cost repairs and high-efficiency systems. We've installed more high-efficiency trained systems than any trained dealer since 2004. We are a family-owned and operated heating and cooling company. When it's 110 degrees outside and your cooling system fails, you can count on Sun Country Heating and Cooling for fast service. 702-617-8159. That's 702-617-8159.
Are you suffering from neuropathy? Do you experience stabbing pain, numbness, tingling, or a burning sensation in your feet or hands? Are you longing to get the relief you desperately need? If you've been diagnosed with neuropathy or experiencing pain or numbness in your feet or hands, pick up the phone and call Dr. Josh Purcell, D.C. at 702-500-0839 for a free neuropathy seminar. Spots are limited and this seminar will fill up, so call now, 702-500-0839. Our treatments focus on helping your nerves to heal, not just masking your pain with addictive medications. There's no surgery and no use of prescription drugs. So pick up the phone right now and call for a free neuropathy seminar, 702-500-0839. Once again, there are limited spots and this seminar will fill up, so call now, 702-500-0839.
There's no other place like Las Vegas to see. No other place like Las Vegas to be.
All right, we're back now, wrapping up the final segment. We've got some time, though. I want to talk about a bunch of things. Your current show that you're doing and performing around the country in Las Vegas right up until the pandemic or whatever it is.
Right.
Was Two Divas and a Piano. Let's go forward with that.
Well, it's very fun because, you know, Gene and I were already doing Cher and Bill Medley because he did Bill Medley, I did Cher, and we didn't have a Bobby at the time when we started it. So we were doing a very successful show called The Time of Your Life as Bill and Cher. And incidentally, Cher sang backups on Love and Feeling, so that's a nice time. Mm-hmm. But I also one day dressed Gene up as Elton John to do a meet and greet for the Rock and Roll Marathon. And he ended up looking so much like Elton John that I asked him if he could, you know, come on, start singing. You know, you already play the piano. And it was such a stretch for him to, you know, do Elton's voice and to learn how to have an English accent and all of that. So we ended up doing a very successful show as Cher and Elton called Two Divas and a Piano. And we've been doing Zoom shows lately. I believe even the clip that you have a clip of us from a Zoom show.
The clip is from a Zoom show or Microsoft Teams. You know, they're all the same. But we had a company hire us to do a show that in that fashion. We did it in our studio. So I just took some. I took some of the clips from that. So when you hear, you're going to hear Cher talking to someone. It's over. It's over the
computer.
The computer. So it's the timing's a little odd, and it's very strange to do shows with no audience. You know,
and a 3 second delay.
And
yeah.
By the time your stuff gets to them and they get back to you, there's like a 2 or 3 second delay. So it's very awkward. But we had a blast, we call it our virtual concert, mm-hmm. and so we're definitely willing to do more of those. Too, if we need to.
Let's listen.
Yeah.
Saturday night's the night. Saturday night's the night.
I want you to repeat after me. Are you ready?
I'm ready. I
got
you
babe
Ron.
We can say I got you Braun if you must. I mean, if you want to do shameless plugs all day long, it's okay. Are you ready? Here we go.
That's good stuff. That was the Zoom concert, yeah?
Right, yeah.
It's a little interesting to listen to, I think.
Yeah, it's it's such a shift of gears for a performer to not have that live audience. So, like I said, we're willing to do those if we need to for a bit longer, but we're really hoping we get the live audiences back real soon. You know.
So, Heidi, what's going on these days? What are you working on? What have you done with this time that we've all spent at home?
Well, several things. We've done over the past year and a half 10 casino jingles for Canada. Gene's been busy in his studio doing music for some shows. And what's really fun is we got a project on spec to do for a drag queen who has written a novel and 22 original songs to go with the novel. So Gene and I are producing and arranging all the songs for that. So that should be a fun thing. I hope it takes off and we get lots of royalties and we can move to Georgia.
Why Georgia?
We did a concert there not too long ago and fell in love with this Lake Hartwell place. It was just so serene and beautiful. And, you know, we're kind of tired of the cement.
Now, Gene, you spent all your life in your studio, right? The one that you built that behind your place.
Yeah, I started,
just about,
yeah,
right?
I started building my studio in the 80s, mid-80s, and it's taken over my life. Yeah, yeah, it's great.
So you have some more music here from your studio work?
Is yeah,
that what
got,
the next clip
yeah,
is?
Cause, yeah.
Okay, let's play that next clip. Now, you're playing all the instruments there, Gene?
Well, here, actually, I hired a whole horn section, including some of the guys playing for Celine Dion now. But usually I play most of the instruments. I bring in a guitar player, a sax player when I need to, but otherwise I play pretty much everything, yeah.
Tom, what do you think of the show today? How do you see things going forward? Do you like these guys? Do you think that
these
music
guys
was great?
They're absolutely fantastic. I want to see them play. I want to see them play live.
Right.
With a bunch of other people.
Now, tell me a little bit about a Zoom concert. How does that work? That's something
basically,
that everybody's talking about?
Yeah, basically you set up cameras in wherever you're performing, and they get those pictures and sound on their computer, and they can bring in as many people as they want to watch. So you basically see little one-inch cubicles on your computer screen to all the people that are tuned in and watching.
Heidi Thompson, Gene Cerronin, thank you so much for joining me today on the Las Vegas Rocks Radio Show. Tom Hillary, see you next week, yeah?
You got it.
We got a good mob show going. We're not supposed to talk about the mob, by the way.
It doesn't exist, don't you know?
We're going to talk about Casino de Paris, apparently. Thank you for listening to the Las Vegas Rocks Radio Show, dedicated to the promotion, motivation, and encouragement of local entertainers, singers, musicians, and the venues they operate in, magicians, songwriters, jingle makers, tribute artists, everybody that's here in town that we want to see working out there more than ever now. We need to give you a platform to tell the world about where you're going and what you're going to do. The Las Vegas Rocks Radio Show is here for you. Let me know when you plan to reopen, and this show will offer you a place to talk about it. Thanks to Jim Dallas. Thanks to Tom Hillary. Thanks to Tammy Morelli, my fiance, for all your help tonight. Next week, we're going to have Marlene Rieke and Arthur Shanker Jr. and a special guest to go with that as we talk about the movie The Irishman and Jimmy Hoffa.
All right.
Awesome. Good night and enjoy your Saturday night.
Under the lights, Vegas nights, I'll always remember the love that we share. Vegas nights. Vegas nights.
Live from the world-famous Las Vegas Strip, AM 670 KMZQ, 70 KMZQ, 70 KMZQ.